Hello and welcome to a brand new show that takes you to some of the coolest hospitality hotspots around. The places in the Northeast to see and be seen, where the celebs hang out and where they hide away. This week we've been invited to a wedding. Hope you like the outfit. I'm Josephine Kime and this is Hot Hotels. This week on Hot Hotels, an American's home is his castle, how a US college professor bought a slice of Northumberland. It's a dead cert, why a York racing family has moved into the boutique hotel business. And picture perfect, an award-winning B&B in rural North Yorkshire. I've been planning ahead, and I've already got my name on a room here, as you can see. This hot hotel in Northumberland is over 600 years old, but don't imagine the comfort standards to be medieval because they're anything but. There's even a room with its own private sauna. Later in the show, I'll be talking to the interior designer about how you turn a 14th century castle into a luxury hotel. Langley Castle has 4 stars and was recently named Best Small Hotel in Northumbria for the second time. Excuse me, I've got a wedding to go to. Built in 1350 during the reign of Edward III, the castle is one of the few medieval fortified castle hotels in England. During the 17th century, the estate became the property of the Earls of Derwentwater. The third Earl and his brother took part in the Jacobite risings of 1715 and were subsequently executed in the Tower of London.
My name's Anton Phillips, and I'm the general manager of Langley Castle, and I've been associated with the castle now for 14 odd years. I've been responsible for the day-to-day operation and improvement of the castle. The guests who stay at Langley Castle, they come literally from the four corners of the world. They're coming to stay in a genuine 14th century castle. We have 8 rooms here in the main castle, but 4 are that little bit more special than the others. Radcliffe Room, the Josephine Room, the Greenwich Room, and the Derwentwater Room. All the rooms are all completely different, all individual. We've had a number of celebrity guests come and stay at the castle, some announced, some are not announced. We had J.K. Rowling come and stay. It was booked in her then, her maiden name, and it wasn't until she actually checked into the castle that it was actually recognised who she was. We then offered her the upgrade to a room which had not shown up, which was a little bit difficult. It was no sooner than I got her ensconced in this glorious room than the genuine occupant of that room turned up, and we had to make a very quick double shuffle to make sure everybody was properly accommodated. Weddings at Langley Castle are extremely important. We will be hosting weddings at the castle on 185, 200 occasions per year. We only host 1 wedding a day, and on that day, everything is geared to the success for that particular couple.
Now, you know how Americans love their history. Mainly because they don't have much themselves, and certainly nothing to compare with what we have on this side of the pond. Anyway, imagine you're an American who's dreamed of life in an English medieval castle, and imagine you've got a bit of spare cash. Well, Dr. Stuart Madnick is an American who dreamt of life in an English castle, and well, I guess he had the money because this place can't have come cheap. Stuart, do you mind if I call you Stuart?
That's wonderful.
Okay, you actually own Langley Castle. How did that come about?
It actually was many ways by accident. I had, like many people, I've dreamed of being in a castle, but never really expected to own one. A colleague of mine had a magazine that had an article about a castle for sale in England. And just out of curiosity, I wrote away for the brochure. And it's intriguing to me. And I was going to be traveling to the UK soon thereafter, and I made arrangements to stop by. And I just looked at the place and almost immediately fell in love with it. And the rest is history.
Stuart, can I be cheeky and ask you how much you actually paid for the castle?
Actually, it was quite a bit of money, but not as much as it could have been. It turns out I bought the castle in 1985, and that's a very key year, because that was the year the British pound hit parity with the US dollar. And right now, the pound is worth almost twice as much. So it was a bargain at the time.
And do you have any experience of running a hotel?
In my real life, I'm a professor of computer technology at the University in Boston, Massachusetts, in the USA. I have never had any experience in running a hotel, but my wife and I have traveled a lot. My wife Yvonne and I have traveled a lot and really have learned over the years what we like and what we don't like in hotels. We try to incorporate that into Langley Castle, and particularly in trying to make it a comfortable, cozy place, a romantic place, trying to draw upon our experiences and our likes and hopefully share that with the rest of the world. The problem is staying here, because unfortunately or fortunately, we have so many weddings which book all of our rooms 6, 9, 12 months ahead of time. Often I can't get in. In fact, tonight I can't even stay here.
Oh, no room at the inn for you.
That's the problem.
So do you prefer being in England than you do being over in America?
Well, they're actually, many ways of very different lives. If you will, there's kind of the high-tech life in the States, and there's a bit of the ancient life here in trying to deal with the issues of a castle. So it really is complementary, and I think the variety makes it exciting.
Thank you, Stuart. What do you think of my throne? Very posh and Bex, isn't it? Welcome back. I'm Josephine Keim, and this is Hot Hotels. This week, we're at Langley Castle in Northumberland, where we're guests at a wedding, and hopefully I'll be having a chat with the bride and groom a bit later on. Now, this is a genuine 14th century castle, and in many ways it still feels like it. But I like my creature comforts, and the idea of medieval plumbing isn't really my thing. So how do you turn a 600-year-old building into a luxury hotel with all the mod cons that a 21st century guest would expect? Well, the woman who appears to have done it here is interior designer Melanie Brown, who's based in Sunderland. Melanie, you've created a luxury hotel, but you've maintained the character of the castle. How have you done that?
Langley Castle's been a 10-year labour of love. It's been lots of time and enthusiasm, lots of effort by everybody, and with a transatlantic client who's American, who has a fantastically eccentric French wife, it's been very difficult, but I think we've achieved it now.
What were the main problems that you encountered?
Well, I think the fact that the castle is 14th century is going to come with all of its own problems. But I think with local craftsmen and specialist skills and help from the planning department and all the different things that make a scheme work, I think that we've overcome them all. There's nothing you can't overcome, I don't think.
Absolutely. And do you have a favourite room in the hotel? And if you do, why? Why is it your favourite?
Well, the drawing room, we have lots of stone exposed. We have lots of sumptuous reds and golds and braids. And the client, she's very fussy in particular, and she loves ornate design. All the rooms are very, very different, and they all have their own specialist feature. I think here what we've created is a cosy, warm space that you're sitting in a huge big space in a huge big room, but it feels quite cosy and warm and intimate, and I think that's really important in a hotel.
Thank you, Melanie. Well, the wedding celebrations are in full swing here at Langley Castle, as you can see, but the bride and groom have taken a moment or two away from their guests to have a quick chat with us. Philip and Elizabeth, first of all, many congratulations.
Thank you.
Both look absolutely wonderful. How has your day gone so far?
It's been absolutely wonderful. We couldn't have wished for a better day.
That's been fabulous.
Yeah.
What is it that you like about Langley Castle in particular?
It's just such a fabulous place. It's a real castle, yet there's a luxury hotel within the walls. We'd been to Langley on a romantic weekend, hadn't we?
Yeah.
And we decided that it'd be wonderful to get married here, basically. We just think it's a fabulous place. And it's fairy tale, really, isn't it?
What's your suite like? Have you already seen it?
Yeah, I have. It's really, really nice. The Radcliffe room we're in. Four poster there.
Sauna, I believe. I haven't seen
the
sauna
yet.
Yes,
there is a sauna there as well.
That's brilliant. Well, thank you very much for inviting Hot Hotels to your wedding. And we hope that you have a long and happy future together.
Thank you very much.
Well, that's it this week from Langley Castle. Join us again next time and we'll have more Northeast Hot Hotels for you to enjoy. See you soon. Cheers.
Next time on Hot Hotels, Manhattan style in Harrogate, yes, on a